Okay, so we are here presenting some live contents related to AI and architecture, and I'm kind of testing softwares and seeing some new possibilities with design. And I want to talk about this software here. It's called Swap. So what is the idea of this software? It's a software that you can bring a project idea and will create the all project documentation using AI. So let's understand about the promise of the software and what it can really do, right? So how we can improve our architectural productivity. So let's take a look on this video here. So we just click on play. So here we can see we can define the project location inside the software. So we are taking a look on that. So we just add the software location. Okay, we capture this location. We drag this and we enter the building site. And okay, so you can set up the apartment, the type of apartment. So you can see here, for example, a prefab standard, dormitories standard, UK standard, IL standard. I don't know what is IL, but maybe Illinois. I'm a strange UK, Illinois, I don't know. Basic design and high-end design. Okay. I don't like this possibility is like, it's kind of simplifying architecture. I don't think architecture is something simple as this, but let's keep going. So building rights, 3 rooms, the square meterage of the each apartment, okay, so target. It will have a penthouse, number of apartments, square meterage. And you can see here it separates between primary area and common area. So this is something interesting because depending on the situation that you have, the location, the jurisdiction, right? You have different building codes, and sometimes you will have, for example, here, for example, when I used to develop high buildings, for example, apartments and things like this. Usually, the common area is something like 40 square meters, 42 apartment, even 4 apartment per floor. So it's bringing here an idea of 6 square meters, and primary area is okay. So it's bringing more like a process related to the jurisdiction, or actually, so bringing these areas, and you can really fine-tune the design. So let's keep going and take a look. Building floor height is nice. So 3.4 meters. Balconies, okay, 12 square meters per apartment. For example, in my city, it's up to 10 square meters. You don't count that into the coefficient of your building, so it's nice to understand this. And let's keep going. So it's adding all the information. So it's telling that it's 4 rooms. Each room will have, the apartment will have 95 to 120 square meters. I think for 4 rooms, this is too small, but let's see what it's going to do. Okay, max stories, fitness area. So here we are adding the communal space. So okay, we have a lobby. Okay, the ratio. Okay, square meters. I don't know what is this ratio here. Maybe it's related to the people. It's kind of maybe too much. Okay, main room, tenant club, fitness. All right, so let's keep going. Mechanical, nice. Yeah, we have some ideas here of having a mini central or a variable refrigerant flow project. It will change the shape, of course. So let's see what it's going to bring. So it's bringing project ideas more in this. I can see that people in the real estate development would love that. There's more pasteurized architecture. These people would love something like it. Tell me your opinion in the comments. I would love to know. Okay, now we have these options of this building massings, and we have so this volume, we have cost orientation. So the apartment areas, the costs, this is something very interesting. See something like this right up at the beginning. So energy analysis, wow. So cooling, heating, energy use intensity. I don't know what it's bringing related to the U value of the project, for example, on the walls, on the glazing. I don't know how it's being processed. How much is this processing? It's very very fast to see the all this content. I don't think they are analyzing too much related to energy efficiency, because just energy modeling just for one building would take a time for this processing here of this four or five interactions. So it's analyzing cost, analyzing lots of shapes, considering the. So it's fantastic. If it's bringing also an energy modeling, it's fantastic. I don't think it's bringing. Okay, let's see. Sun analysis, radiation. So we saw there the radiation analysis. Let's see here. Radiation. So bringing the radiation. Let's see. So these are the phase that is we have more radiation. And then we have this phase that we have less radiation. We see that it's kind of true, right? The roof here is less, there is less radiation because we are right below this tower, the cooling tower here, or the water storage. Okay, so detailed 3D section in seconds. So okay, it's bringing all the 3D and project ideas, multiple views. Okay, this is something cool, right? You don't need to add the details on the project. It's bringing the entire thing and even the dimensions here. I used to do that on AutoCAD. Actually, I did that by hand for a little time, and here making this on I did a lot on AutoCAD, so it's more a very painful process. So here we see that we are not even bringing this beam processing that is very quick to make a dimension. We are bringing something automatic. So it's fantastic. Let's see, full generated. Man, all the sections, all the elevations, details, architectural details of all things. So all the sections of the project, all the plans export to PDF. Guys, just to say, I'm not receiving anything from this website here. I'm just making my natural reaction because I think this is fantastic. If this delivers what it promised, and of course we would like to bring more of our architectural interactions and creativity into the process, but just this thing, I wanted to bring my model, my ideas. I didn't want to see interactions. I wanted to bring my ideas and interact with this and make my energy simulations and all those things, mixing creativity with sustainability. And I just wanted this to bring all automatic documentations. This what I would sleep very happy with this, only with this. I didn't want the first part, but this is fantastic. Let's see. Okay, ready for construction. Code compliant. All those details related to the bathrooms, the kitchens, and the laundries. Okay, it's bringing also the HVAC project. Man, this is very cool. Swap, you should pay me because I'm very excited for this. Okay. So, map elevations, HVAC, finished floor plans. Very, very, very cool. It's bringing a rendering as well. Okay, so guys, this is fantastic in my opinion. This is from 1 year ago, and I think it's having lots of evolutions. Let's take a look on their website and see how we can. Okay, we need to contact them. So it's not for everyone, right? I think it's not something that's as simple as this. So, okay, we need to fill a form to make that possible. So this is a promise. Applies intelligent advanced algorithms to deliver accurate, detailed, and complete architectural construction documents and BIM models faster than ever before. Cost savings, completed project. This is not too much, right? Okay, so how architects benefit from SWAP, increase growth, deliver great buildings consistently, seamless revisions. Okay, they have some companies here too that are using this, some architects as well. So this is a big, big promise. Let's see this institutional video very quickly here. 1 minute.
Hi, Alice. Glad I caught you.
Hi, David. How's the Main Street project?
We got the green light, but we need to get things moving and fast. So when can we meet through? Say, 2 weeks?
No need for that. Just give me a few moments to upload the details. Here.
Take a look at B.
Okay. This is cool. Right, but you are just removing all the value of your work, right? Okay, I'm just creating something that AI is going to create. This is my opinion, how it's going to value people's time, right? Because human work, we need to have human work to make something valuable. And when you are bringing something for free like this, people will see, okay, this is the software that are doing things. And this is something that kind of stressed me when I'm drawing, you know, a very crazy detail, and I'm bringing this to our Instagram channel. And people, you know, if you see our Instagram channel, we are creating some drawings that we do by hand, and just to make sure. So we just uploaded this, and so we are creating this crazy animations here. And sometimes people are telling, okay, which software have you done this? Okay, the software had, you know, people are underestimating your work. And then I say, I was, I spent 4 hours drawing this thing and animating and putting to the video and creating the animation. How you can say this for me? What is the software? You are undervaluing my work. Maybe it wasn't your attention, but think about it, man. And here's the same thing, right?
Wow, and I thought asking for only 2 weeks was pushing it. This is great.
And this person telling, this is great, but you know, since it's too fast to make it, can we charge a little less for this?
But
or maybe can you tell me the software that you are using for this?
We update the facade to what we used in the will.
So what is going to be the value of architects in this process? This is something for us to think. I'm not assuming anything here, but we need to think, what are the things that we are going to bring to the table? Okay, I want to bring to the table all the creativity part of that, all the analysis that we have done and that we really have done. And you know, it needs to have some things for us to analyze and bring this, all our creativity and analysis on the process to bring value.
Some project? Sure, like this.
Yeah, and this girl is bringing all the thing.
Are these the full set of construction documents?
Yep, code compliant, fully coordinated with structural systems and MEP.
This girl is doomed. This guy will ask for 30 revisions now.
Let your GC know we're all set for the permit.
Let SWAP help you automate your architectural processes to improve productivity and increase profit margin. Why wait? Visit SWAP.net today.
Okay, so I think this will be used a lot, maybe in real estate companies, you know? Okay, we are going to develop new products and let's have an internal team to use that and develop the models and all those things. Maybe it's a possibility. I don't know, guys, what do you think about it? Please tell me in the comments, okay? I would love to hear your opinions about it.